I'm supposed to do with all these leftover feelings of you, 'cause I don't know. And tell me how I'm supposed to feel when all these nightmares become real, 'cause I don't know. And I don't think you see the places inside me that I find you. Separate the lies here from the truth. Don't know how we woke up one day, somehow thought we knew exactly what we're supposed to do. So leave me at the roadside and hang me up and out to dry. So leave. Places inside me that I found you. I don't know how we woke up one day, somehow thought we knew exactly what we're supposed to do.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, there was a laugh. Welcome over here to the Dascar Star Super Speedway Series Season 4 2013 on RTL7. We are here at Piggz Cliff Super Speedway for the Listen Up, not the 123 Inks 500, but the Paul Walker 500. Ladies and gentlemen, you may not know Paul Walker, you may not have heard it already, but Paul Walker, actor of the Fast and Furious films, he played Brian O'Connor, passed away yesterday in a very tragic accident. He was on his way to a convention, I think, for his charity, and on his way there he crashed. He was driving, I'm not sure what car he was driving. I thought from the pictures that I saw it was either a Porsche or a Ferrari, and he crashed. Well, he was not driving himself, but somebody else was driving, and he was also killed. So very tragic accident. So this race is in honor of him. Paul Walker 500, rest in peace. So back to some more happy news. We got over here Alex Capps in the 3 car on the pole position. Danica Kalisia on his outside, and third is Cassie Spengler in the 00 car. So I'm not sure if I have any stories actually, except for that it is, well, I do want to mention this, but this is the final race before the chase. No, the final race for me as a 17-year-old. Because coming Tuesday, in about 2 days, I will turn 18. So I'm very happy with that. Really exciting. The next race will be a Philips Cup Series race next weekend. I'm going to celebrate my birthday next weekend, so I will only do one race then. Star Super Speedway Series will be the weekend after that. So race number 6 over here. And, well, I saw a couple of drivers have already commented on the first part. They are fine now. They don't have to comment anymore if they don't want to. And we still have 41 drivers who still have to comment. So, well, ladies and gentlemen, I'm not going to do any more talking. I'm going to get this race underway. And this is going to be a strange race, ladies and gentlemen. Well, the thing is, I still haven't solved the problem with the crashing under caution. But the thing is, I don't know how to fix it. I know how to fix it. I do what we gotta have to do is the pace car has to either come out earlier, or he has to gain more speed quickly, because when he immediately pulls out of pit road, he doesn't go faster than 120 miles per hour, and all the cars come storming in with 200 miles per hour, so they eventually have to stop and brake and crash into each other. So that's a little bit annoying. This may as well be, therefore, if I cannot fix that, this may be the last time that we will go to Piggz Cliff. On the other hand, the racing is going to be fantastic, I hope. So, ladies and gentlemen, the green flag is out here at Piggz Cliff with Alex Capps in the lead. Alex Capps in the 3 car gets the advantage over Danica Calissia. And Cassie Spengler in the 00 car is going forward. By the way, we haven't had any flips this weekend so far. We haven't had any flips in 2 weekends, actually. Well, make that in 5 weekends for so, because of me being away with laptop problems. But ever since we have, since with my new laptop, we haven't had any flips. But I have a feeling that will change. In the qualifying race, we had like 3 or 4 flips, so. Danica Calissia in the 49 car suddenly found some more speed, probably with a right-hander. And now she's going underneath the 3 car of Alex Capps. Question is, can they survive this turn or not? That's the question. And this is most of the times the trouble spot. Everybody in the back seem to be going fine. Still fine. And we completed one lap. And indeed, we are still green flag racing. Oh, but this is a little bit tight over here. So, Danica Calissia, here comes Betty Cox in the 03 car. Andy Timmons is there as well in the 83 car. And you see the 7 car, Jennifer Duke. Still no caution. I'm really waiting for the caution, so. I hadn't expected it. Well, we had a qualifying race without any cautions, but in the test race I did a few moments ago, we had 3 cautions, so. It will most likely be either 1, 2, or 3 cautions. Not too many. But that's fine. So now, Betty Cox in the lead. Andy Timmons, the points leader, right behind him. Important thing is that Andy Timmons is in the race. We should actually look at all the points leaders. The 88 car, second in points. Nick Capps is not in his race. Jacques Robinson in 16 car is in his race. Oh, contact! Couple of cars going around. Quick! Oh, that was weird. And we got over here the 42 cars crashing, the 26 car Jordan Calder is in there, Nathan Mitchell, 42 Saya, assuming she's done for the day. And possibly some other cars were involved in this as well. There we see Saya Asumi on pit road. But these guys are still green flag racing. I'm not sure who is all under caution. I think there's a clear line, you can see that. Yeah, these guys are already slowing down and under caution, so. There, Jeffrey Buckeye making pit stop 6 in points, so that's not really good for him. Here are some more cars smoking. But it's still Betty Cox in the 03 car in the lead. Andy Timmons and Jennifer Duke following him. Well, Jennifer Duke is part of Betty Cox's team, so. Coming back to the line over here. And then hopefully they will not crash again. Ooh, close, all over there. And there's the pace car. And this is what I mean with problem. There, look at the pace car. It is so slow. And it's even slowing down. Well, it needs to speed up because everybody here is flying by. So, that's the thing. If that pace car could get more speed, then the problem with crashing on the caution may be solved. But I already tried to tweak a little bit with the track info file. So, the bunching distance is a little bit bigger. But most likely these cars that will come in are going to crash into this. So, yeah. There are Dustin Capps. Oh, I think Dustin Capps may be fine. So far it seems like nobody crashed into somebody else. But I gotta double check that if it stays like this. Oh, there are a couple of cars run into each other. There are a 55 car. Makoto Iguchi, that is, I believe, yes indeed. And Zachary Fitzwater. So, luckily, they saved it. They did not crash into each other. Ladies and gentlemen, first caution of the day after 2 laps. Let's take a look what happened over here. Actually, 2/3 laps. Let's take a look what happened over here. First caution of the day. So, this is where it went wrong. Most likely, the 42 car of Saya Asumi is going to get turned by the 26 car of Jordan Culp over here. And you're going to see that right here. Yes, and their contact is made and turn into the 0 car. Nathan Mitchell nowhere to go, so that's a tough break for Nathan Mitchell. And they are just spinning and crashing over here. I don't think that anything else happened, so it's only a 3 car incident over here. So, that's fairly fine. Let's take one more look at this. Jordan Culp. Well, this is the trouble spot of the racetrack, that last turn. And sometimes they go to the outside wall, sometimes they go to the inside wall. This time it was the inside wall. Sanya Sumi out of the race. Jordan Culp most likely out of the race. I think that the zero car, Nathan Mitchell, may be able to continue, looking at the damage, which he almost does not have. So, and there the 42 cars already on pit road. So it is Batty Cox in the lead. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you to the green flag. Ladies and gentlemen, we are back again live, and that's why we're a little bit late. Batty Cox in the lead. Annie Timmons is second. Third, Jennifer Duke. Fourth, Sean Howell. Fifth, the 30 car of Daniel Voyles. Sixth, Emily Michaels. Seventh, Sander Kors. Eighth is the 52 car of Lee Hong. Ninth is Molly Black. And 10th is Jane Pinter. That's your top 10 over here. A couple of cars are out of this race. As here you can see, the 42 car is out of the race. And this 26 car, Jordan Culp and Sai Asumi in the other way around. And the zero car can't continue. Ooh, somebody blowing up. And that's Nick Pericles in the 33 car blowing up. So that's a tough break for him. His race is over as well, most likely. So Batty Cox in the 03 car. Here comes the move by Jennifer Duke. Seventh car of Jennifer Duke. She's on a roll. She has qualified herself for, I think, three races in a row or so. Or maybe even four races in a row. I'm not sure how many races. But she's now 40th in points. So slowly but surely climbing. And if she can get a good finish over here, that's going to be big for her. Annie Timmons in the 83 car. Oh yeah, we were looking at the points leaders who were in the race. Moonlight Taylor is in the race. Dom Capps is not, I believe. No, indeed, he is not. Fifth in points, he is. Jeffrey Buckeye is in the lead, but he's in the back of the field. 44 car is seventh in points, not in the field. Cole Daly is in the field in the 81 car. Nicole Trenovic in the 70 car is not in the field. And Keith Batson, 10th in points, is of course in the field. And here we got some great racing over here. We got Batty Cox and Jennifer Duke going after each other, two teammates. While Sander Kors slides in third position, fourth now Molly Black. All women up front. Okay. And look at Sander Kors trying to get a run over here. There you go. And she goes to the inside of Batty Cox as well, but she's now on the outside of in the next turn. Here she is on the outside, so Batty Cox is in the advantage again. Now is Jennifer Duke trying to get back again, but this will not be enough for Jennifer Duke as this turn is left-hander. And we're already halfway home. So that's after 10 minutes. This is really a short race. Should extend it. Oh well. Doesn't really matter. I think you don't mind having short races. So, skimming through the field. And there's the zero car. Nathan Mitchell. He has a little bit more damage than I initially had expected. And there's Makoto Higuchi on pit road. Oh, did I hear somebody? No, okay. Oh, now I hear people crashing! And the 87 car is on his roof! Matthew Davey flipped over in that thing. There he is, flipping wildly! Matthew Daly on his roof. Sliding over here. We got a huge incident. We see also Nesmith Brown, Zachary Robinson, Zachary Fitzwater involved. There, the 41 John Shipman, and I think indeed the 39 car, the two Haas cars are involved in this thing. Also, Devin Whitson in his first start, Debbie Myers. So, huge incident over here. And now, racing back to the line, it is Molly Black in the lead in the 14 car. Enormous incident over here, and I think Matthew Daly hit that inside wall extremely hard as he got really, really shot him back up the racetrack. And now the two teammates, Molly Black and Kevin Waters, are going side by side. And Kevin Waters takes the lead and leads them back to the line. Look at how few cars are left in this lead group. And there's the stupid pace car again. Look at how slow it is. Well, here are some more cars. I think, well, a lot of cars have damage. There you see, the Pulsar Alex Capps has damage. And there's the 39 to 57. 41 car John Shipman, Debbie Myers. Sean Howell also with a lot of damage. There are Daniel Voyles. Also Zachary Fitzwater. Nathan Mitchell. 8th car of Emily Michaels. And there are a lot of damage as well too. Is this, yeah, Annie Thomas in the 93 car. Yeah, the 55 car. Coming back. Ooh, that was a pass. still counts. And a couple of drivers are on pit road over here. And how about the crashing under court? Now I have a feeling that now they are going to crash into each other. Unless, well... Actually, these guys are doing pretty good, so... If they can keep it up like this, then it's going to be fine. What I changed about this, I changed the pacing speed from 70 or 75 miles to 100 miles per hour behind the pace car, and so that goes a little bit faster. And also the bunching the pacing distance, I changed that a little bit. So, well, that seems to be working out so far. So we got Kevin Waters in 25 car in the lead, ladies and gentlemen. The big one happened over here. Matthew Davey flipping over. A lot of cars involved. Let's take a look what happened over here. Second caution of today. Ladies and gentlemen, you are not going to believe this accident. Matthew Davey went for the right of his career over here. Take a look what happened over here. Matthew Davey will get turned by Sean Howell in the 38 car. That will send him into the outside wall. And then this was already going to look pretty bad. But then the thing is, he bounced back. And there, he gets hit by Daniel Voiles. And up on two wheels. And now it's going to turn all upside down for him. And he's going to flip over the pit wall over here. Matthew Davey over the pit wall. The second car this season that has flipped over the pit wall. After Sean Howell flipped over the pit wall at M&M Super Speedway. But that is going to get even worse. He's going to flip over the pace car over here, straight through the pace car. And then he hits that wall over there. That shoots him right up into the track, right into the 43 car, the 93 car. And he's going to tumble even more on his roof. Matthew Davey. Extreme crash for Matthew Davey. Insane is this. And now just sliding on this roof over there. Sparks flying, smoke everywhere. And he's going to slide into Nesmith Brown, Devin Whitson, maybe even two. No, he doesn't hit the 57 car. But he hits Nesmith Brown, who almost flips over then. It's an extreme crash over. Let's get another look at this. Insane. I have never seen anything like this before. Look at this. Here we go. Contact made, full speed, flips over the pit wall, and just flipping over more and more, and hits that weird wall, and then gets into Jeffrey Buckeye, Annie Thomas, and just continues sliding on his roof. This will be an insane onboard. But first, let's take another look at what happened to Sean Howell then, and all the others that were involved, because, well, there we go. Sean Howell, and he gets into Ray Takeda. Actually, we should take a look at Ray Takeda. Ooh, oh man, hang on. Damn. 48 car Zachary Robinson hit that wall head on over there. There, he gets hooked by Ray Takeda, shoots into the wall head on. Cole Daly does an amazing job missing that. Oh, another car flipped though. Zachary Robinson also went on his roof. Oh, wow, I did not expect that. And there the 87 car comes bouncing back into the field again. So we're going to write down. We got two flips over here. Zachary Robinson and Matthew Davey. So that leads to five flips in the season for the races. That's not too many. I'm really surprised. Only five flips in six races so far. And five flips in the qualifying races as well. So let's see. Here. Also Alex Capps, and then, oh yeah, Alex Capps flipped him over, and then all the damage here, our car spinning, two Haas cars, synchronized spinning, look at that, oh man, look at this, they are just synchronized spinning over here, that's amazing, that's completely synchronized, wow, then you have the two cars, both involved in this crash, and not only that, they are synchronized spinning. That's insane. Look at that. And they continue also synchronized over here. That's amazing. That's beautiful. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to take some onboards over here. First, let's go to the 87 car of Matthew Davey. Matthew Day, I'm not sure where he was in points. Not too good, I think. Well, can't find him. Christmas lights are getting hung up on the roof over here, so my dad is making a little bit of noise. Here we go, Matthew Daly on board over here. Gets hooked by Sean Howell into the wall, and oh no, here we go. Over the pit wall. Flipping over. Wall! Racetrack, cars. And up and over. And he will not come back again, so we'll rewind. One more on board, and then we'll go back to live racing again. Let's go to the number 48 car of Zachary Robinson. Also, he flipped over. Wait. Did I just see some other people crash? I thought that I just saw two others crash. Oh, hang on. Oh, man. Jane Pinter got sent into the wall over there by Emily Michaels. What happened over here? I had not seen that happening. That was completely in the back of the field, so look at this. Oh, that's new. Oh, hard hit though for both. I hope that they are alright, but... Well, and then everything went even more wrong in front of them. More wrong, is that a moron? That sounds like moron. I'm not allowed to say that, maybe. Oh well, don't care. On board with Zachary Robinson over here. And first there you see Jane Pinter disappearing, hitting the wall. And now things will get even worse in front of him. There. No, that's a shame. And then he gets flipped over by the three car of Alex Capps. And spins around Devin Whitson. And there are the two Haas cars. And there is... Oh, hello, Matthew Daly. So, ladies and gentlemen, Daniel Voyles involved together with some teammates. And there's where the 8th car came from. I thought that she was done for the day, but, well, she might be. So it was not Molly Black, but teammate Kevin Waters in the lead. Oh, well. Ladies and gentlemen, time to take you to the green flag once again. Ladies and gentlemen, the lights are not out on the pace car yet, but they will go off in a few moments. We got a 25 car of Kevin Waters in the lead. Second is Keith Batson. Molly Black in third. Sonne Kors in fourth. Fifth is Cassie Spengler. Nika Kalusia in sixth. Seventh is the 03 of Betty Cox. Moonlight Taylor in eighth. Ooh, that's important for her, fourth in points. Ninth is Joe Onesto. And 10th is Jason Sinclair. Joe Onesto, we haven't talked about the Onesto people in this race yet. And also John Cittadino is with both cars not in the field, so that's a tough break for John. And Prunes Little John. Okay, that's fun. So now the pace cars are off on the lights. Yeah, that's it. And here you can see, well, we're not live, so you don't really see who's out of the race. But Jane Pinter is out of the race. I think the 43 cars as well. There's Jane Pinter still on pit road. Okay, that's possible as well. Fine. And I'm not sure about the others. Well, Matthew Daly is out. Zachary Robinson, Renesmee Brown, Jeffrey Buckeye are out as well. And I think that Alex Capps and Annie Thomas are also out. Ellie-Anne didn't even qualify. So ladies and gentlemen, when we go green flag racing, we'll have four laps to go. Four laps to decide who will be the winner of this race. And we'll see plenty of passing. Kevin Waters in the lead. Lead them back to the green flag. Question is, we might as well see another crash. So that's also possible. So you want to be up front as soon as possible and as long as possible. You don't want to wait till the end to make your move, because if the caution comes out, it's all over. That's it. Moonlight Taylor. Well, she's not making a move yet, but I was actually referring to Molly Black. Molly Black is on the course working together on the left lane. Right lane is Keith Batson and Cassie Spengler. And now we got the teammates over here. 1-2. 14 Molly Black chasing down the 25 of Kevin Waters. Kevin Waters in the number 25 Oakley scheme, which is the best car he has ever driven. And now he's trying to do the same thing as what Kelly Waters did at South Boston in the Phillips Cup Series, and that is win. But I think Molly Black still has to make something still has not decided what they should do. Oh, crash, crash, crash. Caution out. We're done. Over. No, we're not done, actually. That was too early. This was too early. Because I think we'll go green flag racing then. With one more lap to go. Okay. I think we're going to have a one lap shootout. So everybody's slowing down under caution. And now we're going to get the cars running into each other. Not. Probably. I don't even know what happened over here. Oh, there you see the 8 car, only Michaels. And Sean Howell, Jason Sinclair, Joseph Ernesto, Debbie Myers, Jacques Rams, Nathan Mitchell, Makoto Iguchi. Man, we have a lot of cars over here on pit road. This is the most annoying thing ever. With the green screen coming up. Damn. There, 57 car. Oh, no ignition for Devin Whitson over here coming on pit road. How many cars have we left? We have only a few cars left, I think. Well, let's take a look what happened over here. A lot of cars were involved in this, ladies and gentlemen. Let's take a look at the replays. So this is where it started. It started with Joseph Ernesto making contact with Jason Sinclair. As well, this turn, last turn has been trouble spot all day long. Oh my goodness, that's a really hard hit for Joseph Ernesto. I hope he's all right over there. And then Jacques Robinson has nowhere to go. Important, Jacques Robinson is third in points. And there everybody just spinning and crashing over. Well, not too many cars. I actually had expected that there would... Oh no! These cars were also on pit road! Oh no! Oh my goodness. And there Joseph Ernesto goes on his roof. My goodness. Debbie Myers came straight into it. Sean Howell as well, I think. And Devin Whitson spun around. My. Joseph Ernesto, it goes from a hard hit to even worse as he's flipping over. Oh my goodness. Man, I really hope that Joseph Ernesto is alright after this. He's at least flip number 6 over here. So that's like half the flips came at this race. Alright, there we go. Full speed one more time. Joseph Ernesto, oh my goodness. I blinked over there. That was a really hard hit. I really hope that Joe is alright over here. And then he gets... Oh my. He just gets plowed into by Debbie Myers. And Debbie has done that before, I think. Goodness gracious. Oh. I thought we heard more cars crashing. Oh, there we got Zachary Fitzwater flying in. And he's going to hit the 0 car of Nathan Mitchell. Luckily it wasn't even worse than that. What? No way! There's no way that this just happened over here. Zachary Fitzwater. And then he gets hit by the 8 car and flips over. There's no freaking way that this just happened. This has really been like one of those things. Just, well, screw those brakes. Let's Arca drive these cars. Oh man, this is really pathetic. This is really stupid. I'm not referring to anyone, just this thing that they don't brake and just continue plow driving into this. Well, let's first go on board with Joe Ernesto. Joseph Ernesto. Now I cannot say Joe Ernesto anymore because Joe Ernesto is somebody else, but here we go, on board with Joseph Ernesto. Turns extremely hard into the wall. Gets even worse. Hit by the 16 car. And now I think everything is all over. No. Debbie Myers and Makoto Iguchi come flying into this. And is he going to... Yes, there he is. Ooh, that sounded pretty cool. And I'm going to... Oh my. I think that was the 47 car, but I'm not sure. I'm not sure at all if that was the 47 car. But somebody suddenly came flying on over. Yeah, it was the 47 car. Oh man, there was not driver side, luckily. Zachary Fitzwater. In his first start over here. Well, let's go on board over here with Debbie Myers. And this is how you make a race longer. Indeed, showing replays of 20 minutes. While a race would only last like, what is it? Maybe 15, 20 minutes. Well, I don't mind if you skip these replays. I just show them for whoever wants to see them. On board Debbie Myers over here. Yeah, smoke. You could say that she... That there's... Oh, yeah, there's just... As soon as the 60, what car saw I flip over there? Was it Joe Nesto? Yeah, I think it was Joseph. Ooh, look at Joseph Nesto just flying over there. Now on board over here with Zachary Fitzwater. To make it even worse, another car comes flying in and gets plow drive. And he wasn't even going up, wasn't even really up to speed, so there he goes, smoke everywhere, and he just thinks, well, never mind, I will just be a part of this as well. Not a very smart move, and well, eventually he's the one who gets turned over up and on his roof by Emily Michaels. So I'm not sure if anything else happened over here. I think we have had enough as well. So, ladies and gentlemen, Kevin Waters in 25 cars in lead. Let's take you to the green flag. Possibly, most likely, we'll just check. I'm pretty sure we're going to have a one-lap shootout, and if not, you will see that. Ladies and gentlemen, green flag over here or the finish. Ladies and gentlemen, this race has really turned out to be a battlefield. We have only a few cars left over here. We got 25 car of Kevin Waters in the lead. Teammate Molly Black is right behind him in second. Sonnekorst is in third. Fourth is Keith Batson. Oh, damn, you screwed up my whole lineup. Derp. Moonlight Taylor is in 5th. Danica Clissia is in 6th. 7th is Joe Nesto. 8th is the 7th car of Jennifer Duke. 9th is Cassie Spengler. And 10th is Betty Cox. Skim through the whole field. 6, 7, 8, 9, 20. 21 cars are still left. I'm not sure if there are more. Probably have missed them because they... Yeah. 21 cars left. There we go. Everybody's out of this race. Well, I will just show you very quickly. There you see. Everyone, 31, 62, 16, 78, and 67, 55, 57, 55, 0. And all the others were already out of the race. Here you can see just quickly showing this. So this race suddenly turned out to be a battlefield. And how is the battlefield going to end? Indeed, with a one-lap shootout. Kevin Waters versus Molly Black versus Sonnekorst versus everybody else who's right behind there. Apparently they don't want to do a one lap shootout. Well, that's fine as well. I have seriously thought that we would have a one lap shootout. I was sure of that, but apparently they just don't want to have a one lap shootout. So that would hand the lead to 25 car of Kevin Waters. And actually this is the second screwed up finish in a row in the Starbucks Super Speedway series after last time screwed up finish. But this time it is not as worse, as this is just, well, extra pace, either extra pace lap or just, well, I think that maybe they do this because of the amount of wrecks we had, and they are afraid that something like we had a few moments ago would happen again, with another more hard crashes, Joseph Nesto, Zachary Fitzwater flipping over, and others just plow driving into that. I think that this may be a precautionary move. Might be as well. So let's see. Oh, we're not done yet. Are we going to fast forward? I don't know. Well, I don't want to. So Kevin Waters in the number 25 car. He won a qualifying race in race number 4 at 8 ball. After that, he has qualified second. He finished second in the second qualifying race at race number 5, and he's finished second in this qualifying race. Started 6th, and 25 car. Of Kevin Waters is going to get a win over here. But I think the more important thing is also that his teammate Molly Black is going to finish in second. So a 1-2 finish for that team. Sonnekorst, great job by her. There's Keith Batson, 10th in points. Oops, quickly. Ladies and gentlemen, finish over here. And it's Kevin Waters winning the race. And a pace car hit the wall over there, I think. Oh, everybody's slowing down. I'll just continue, guys. Come on. Oh, okay. Okay, that is fun. So, official standings, I think. Official standings. 21 cars finished and all the others are just done. So, ladies and gentlemen, just came through over here. There you see, everybody. 14 laps, the race lasted 33 minutes, so it's still pretty long. Kevin Waters won this race. Molly Black, teammate, in second. Sonnecourse, third. Keith Batson in fourth position. Moonlight Taylor in fifth. And important for Moonlight Taylor is that Jacques Robinson and Andy Timmons both did not finish. I think Andy Timmons did not finish. Andy Timmons. Timmons. Oh, he probably did finish, but not. Timmons in 11th, so that's also pretty good for him. Andy Timmons will keep the points lead. Jacques Robinson, though, did not finish, who is third in points. But they will continue with the lineup. Danica Calicia started in second position, and she finished in sixth. Joe Ernesto in seventh position, but he's pretty much concerned about his son, I think. Joseph Ernesto. Jennifer Duke, another top 10 for her. Cassie Spangler, ninth, and 10th is Paddy Cox. So let's see. Jeffrey Buckeye in the 43 car, he was sixth in points. Well, he did not finish too good, 38th. Jeff Stevens was not in the race. Cole Daly in the 81 car, he did finish. He did finish in 13th, so that's pretty good to run for Cole Daly. Then Keith Batson, 10th in points, finished in 4th. So, ladies and gentlemen, that's it. A pretty chaotic race, a couple of extremely hard hits. Hope that these guys are alright. Paul Walker 500, I keep on forgetting his name, but Paul, there's various variation on that, and Walker, yeah, Watson, there's somebody who's named Paul Watson, and he's either, it has something to do with endurance racing commentator, or it was a golf commentator, I'm not sure. So, ladies and gentlemen, we're about done over here. Next weekend, as said, we'll have a Phillips Cup Series race on Sunday. That will be at Richmond, I believe. And for that week after, we're going to have another Starbucks Super Speedway Series race. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll move to the most feared racetrack, Talladega. And you think, what? Why Talladega? Well, this, what you see, the plow driving over here, the car, slower cars just run straight into it, full throttle. Talladega is going to be even worse. So I'm really nervous about that. The Phillips 499 at Talladega. Ladies and gentlemen, man, that was a really crazy race. Kevin Waters picked up his second career win, actually. He won, of course, last time at Lowell. I think it was Lowell. In the 1-2 last race, he won. And he beat Nies Steinhardt was then. And now he's beaten Sonnecourse, who finished in third. And his teammate, Molly Black. Great job by her. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for watching. I will see you next time at Talladega, here with the Dascar Starbucks Super Speedway Series, Season 4, 2013, RTL7. And no crashing under caution, that is great. That's fantastic, that's exactly what I wanted, so.
Up and down. up and out to dry. 'Cause I don't think you see the places inside me that I find. I don't know how we woke up one day, somehow thought we knew exactly.